Isaiah 40:10, behold, the Lord God will come with a strong hand, and his arm shall rule for him, and behold, his reward is with him, and his works before him. Our works are to be judged, and we are to be rewarded for those that endure or last through the fiery judgment. Isaiah 62:11, behold, the Lord has proclaimed to the end of the world, say ye to the daughter of Zion, behold, your salvation is coming. Behold, his reward is with him and his work before him. In Zephaniah 1:14, the great day of the Lord is near. It hastens greatly, even the voice of the day of the Lord. The mighty man shall cry bitterly. And when that judgment comes, those that there will be that bitter cry when men realize their folly of rejecting God's rule over their lives. Jesus said, when the Son of Man shall come in the glory of his Father with his angels, and then shall he reward every man according to his works. Paul said to the Romans 2:6, who will render to every man according to his deeds, to them who by patient continuance in doing good, and they seek for glory and honor, their reward will be immortality and eternal life. But unto them that are contentious and do not obey the truth, but obey unrighteousness, the reward is indignation and the wrath of God. I am the Alpha and the Omega, Jesus said, the beginning and the end, the first and last. He's the total. He's the sum total. The A to the Z, the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning, the end, the first and the last. Isaiah 41:4, who hath wrought and done it, calling the generations from the beginning? I, the Lord, the first and the last, I am he. Isaiah 44:6, thus saith the Lord, the King of Israel and his Redeemer, the Lord of hosts, I am the first and I am the last, and beside me there is no God. Isaiah 48:12, hearken unto me, O Jacob and Israel, my call, for I am he, I am the first and also the last. Back in Revelation chapter 1, verse 8, Jesus said, I am the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning and the ending, saith the Lord, which is, which was, and which is to come, the Almighty. Revelation 1:11, saying, I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last. And what you see, write in a book and send it to the seven churches which are in Asia. And then in Revelation 21:6, he said to me, it is done. I am Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give to him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. Blessed are they that do his commandments, and those that, for they may have the right to the tree of life and enter in through the gates of the city. Genesis 2:9, out of the ground the Lord God caused to grow every tree that is pleasant to the sight and good for food. The tree of life also in the midst of the garden, and the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. And Genesis 3:22, the Lord said, behold, man has become as one of us, to know good and evil. And now lest he put forth his hand and take of the tree of life and live forever. So he drove man out of the garden, and he set the cherubim with this flaming sword, which turned every way to keep the way of the tree of life. There is the promise, though, to the church in Revelation chapter 2, verse 7. He that hath an ear to hear, let him hear what the Spirit says to the churches. For to him that overcomes will I give to eat of the tree of life, which is in the midst of the paradise of God. Verse 15, without, he talks about those that may enter in through the gates into the city. Verse 14, for without the city are dogs, sorcerers, whoremongers, murderers, idolaters, and whosoever loves and makes a lie. Paul wrote to the Corinthians, "Don't you know that the unrighteous will not inherit the kingdom of God? Don't be deceived. Neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate, nor the abusers of themselves with mankind, nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor extortioners shall inherit the kingdom of God." Don't be deceived, Paul said on this. To the Ephesians in chapter 5, Paul wrote, "But fornication and uncleanness or covetousness, let it not once be named among you as become saints. For this you know, that no whoremonger, nor unclean person, nor covetous man who is an idolater has any inheritance in the kingdom of Christ and of God. Let no man deceive you with vain words, for because of these things, the wrath of God is coming upon the children of disobedience." Revelation 9:20, "The rest of the men which were not killed by the plagues, yet they did not repent of the works of their hands, that they should worship the devils and idols of gold and silver and brass and stone and wood, which neither can see nor hear nor walk, neither did they repent of their murders, nor of their sorceries, nor of their fornications, nor of their thefts." Revelation 21:8, "But the fearful, the unbelieving, the abominable, the murderers, the whoremongers, the sorcerers and idolaters, and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burns with fire and brimstone, which is the second death." Now, how many times does God have to tell you something before you believe it? You know, I mean, all of these passages, God is warning you that if you're guilty of these things, that you're not going to inherit the kingdom of heaven. And don't be deceived on this. Don't let someone tell you, "Well, it's all right, you know, it doesn't really matter," because it does. And God is very specific on these things. In verse 16, "I, Jesus, have sent my angel to testify unto you these things in the churches. I am the root and the offspring of David, and the bright and the morning star." So Jesus confirms that I've sent my angel to let you know these things. I am the offspring or the descendant of David, the promised Messiah, the bright and the morning star. And the Spirit and the bride say, "Come." Let him that heareth say, "Come." And he that is thirsty, let him come. And whosoever will, let him take of the water of life freely. This is the invitation that is made to us today. In Isaiah 55:1, "Ho, everyone that thirsteth, come to the waters. He that has no money, come, buy, eat." Jesus answered the woman of Samaria, "If you knew the gift of God, who it is that said, 'Give me a drink,' you would have asked him, and he would have given you living water. Whoever drinks of this water will thirst again." We covered that earlier. "Drink the water that I give, it will be like a well of water springing up to everlasting life." Revelation 21:6, "He said to me, 'It's done. I'm the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning and the end. I'll give to him that is thirsty of the fountain of water of life freely.'" Tonight, you can drink of the fountain of the water of life freely. The door is open. The invitation is there for come and drink of the water of life. Never thirst again. That satisfaction that comes when you know that your sins are forgiven and that you are a child of God.